Hey, what's up? It's Tom here. I'm with my brother Dan.
Hey.
And you know, at every conference, what I like to do is I like to take away as many notes as I can, good notes. So we're coming at you with some love notes, and we're going to be watching some love movies because I know that's like your jam.
Oh, yeah. You
know, that's like your favorite thing to do.
Well, I know that you and Deb love Pride and Prejudice. I know you love it.
Mr. Darcy. He's my man. That's
all. You modeled yourself after the man.
It's our movie. Look at him right here. Look at him. Look at the blousy shirt. Look at the jacket. The riding boots.
He's a stud.
It's like 5:30 in the morning.
Wow, he must really love her. I would have totally told her, hey, can we meet 10:30? Maybe even 11.
That's pretty early. Look at the way he's walking. Look at him. He's a stud. Look at him. It takes forever.
It takes forever. It's a long walk. It's a journey.
Here we go. Close-up shots. Oh, my gosh.
She could have totally, you know, met him halfway, helped him out a little bit.
Yeah, yes, she could have done that. She could have helped him a little bit. Yeah. Look at him right here. Look at him.
You have bewitched me, body and soul.
And I love. He can't get it out. I love you. And then Keira Knightley's like...
Well then...
It's kind of like a whisper. It's like... He's a close talker. There it is.
That's it. That's the whole movie.
You wake up the whole movie for that. It's long, too. It's a 6-hour long movie.
6 hours.
6 hours long for that. That's so good. Next movie, Love Notes, Titanic.
It's terrible.
Okay, so here's the thing I can't figure out. They've known each other for like 3 days.
Exactly.
Are you really going to keep me in the water freezing?
There's room on the raft.
Oh, there
you could fit two people on there.
Let me on the raft. And you know what? We're going to share the life preserver.
Will you please scoot over?
Just if you love me, you'll let me on the raft. No, Titanic. See, here's the thing. If they had been paying attention, they wouldn't have hit the iceberg in the first place. So pay attention. Okay, next movie, Sleepless in Seattle.
Great movie.
Tom Hanks, yeah. Meg Ryan.
Yeah. Oh, they made a ton of movies.
They made a ton of movies together.
Like Sleepless in Seattle.
Castaway.
Apollo 13.
Bridge of Lies. That was a great one they made.
Road to Perdition.
Yeah. That's awesome when they made that movie.
The Green Mile.
Yeah.
Shrek 2. The Terminator. So, what do you like about the movie?
Well, since I haven't seen it in a long time, this is when early technology was taken off. I really like that they were drinking coffee. This is really when coffee started really emerging on the scene.
So we didn't even have coffee in the Americas to the 90s.
No, coffee didn't show up until like 2002. It was
before Y2K, right?
Yeah, Y2K, and then coffee. And how many women went out and got Meg Ryan's haircut?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, my wife did.
Lindsay did.
Yeah.
She was 93. She was like 7.
She was a big fan of Meg.
Well, next up, The Notebook.
Oh, good movie. I cried in the end.
It's exhausting. They're in the rain. They're in the street. They're in the yard. He wants her. He doesn't want her. He's clean shaven.
He has a beard.
He's trying to repair a house.
You just described the first 5 months of my marriage.
You've been married 6 months.
It's a beautiful film.
No, it's not. Now this is a love story.
Probably the greatest love story of all.
It would be ranked as like Romeo and Juliet. You know, I mean, like you think.
I cried.
When you think about Valentine's Day, an anniversary meal, and there comes this moment. You've had a delicious meal. The kids are in bed. And you look at your wife and you say, honey, can we watch Rudy?
Rudy, Rudy.
It is one of the greatest love stories of all time. Yeah, the meaning. Yeah.
When my wife does something great, you know, I'll come up behind her and just dunk Gatorade all over her.
That's beautiful. That's a good idea. Like when grandma has a birthday, you just run into the living room and you just douse her with Gatorade.
Towards dinner, if we're, when we're heading to dinner, I'm just holding up the fort, you know. Yeah, fourth quarter. Coming to the end of that.
Sometimes when, you know, when someone does something great, like when your spouse does something great, you just, it's a good idea to hoist him up on your shoulders, carry him off the field. It's beautiful. Beautiful story.